Errors in C++ can sometimes be horrible, but after about 10 years of doing almost only C++, I learned to understand them, and in this video, I'll give you a 5-step framework to fix them, and we will then talk about real annoying ones like template errors, linker errors, or recursive include errors in bigger codebases. But I will also cover all the basic things. I will show you what Stalin debugging is, I will tell you all the tricks I know, plus some tips to avoid that kind of problems, so stick till the end, because I promise, this video will save you so much time if you use C++ seriously. So, let's go! So, let's start with understanding how C++ compilation works. You will see throughout this video that most of error fixing in C++ is you understanding how the language works. So, this video will be full of common problems examples. So, we have C++ files and header files. C++ files are compiled individually. This is called a translation unit. Then, they're all put together in a process called linking. So, if you get a compiler error, that happens here, and if you get a linker error, that happens here. An example of a compiler error is that you forgot to add a semicolon, while a linker error can be that you called one function in a translation unit, but the linker can't find it anywhere. Now, header files are just placed into the C++ files, so they are compiled only if they are into a CPP file, so you can't get a compilation error from a header file directly. This will be important later. So, literally, when you say include, the content of the header file is copy-paste into the CPP file, and you can do weird stuff like this. Please don't do this though, or I will come to your house. Now, let's move to basic compiler errors. So, the framework to fixing errors starts like this. Step 1, go there, see if you can fix it immediately. If you don't understand what the problem is, step 2 is to read the error message, and I see many beginners not doing that. It is there to help you. Also, in Visual Studio, this window won't give you the full information sometimes, so also open the output window and search for the word error here. If you still can't figure it out, step 3 is to search it online or even ask ChatGPT, he's a very smart guy. Now, for harder errors, this framework will also expand, but first, let me give you some tips. First, if you ever get weird compiler errors or doing complicated pointer stuff, that error might suggest that you did something wrong. So, don't just force cast the pointer. Try to reread your code, because the compiler is trying to tell you that you did something wrong. Yes, this happened to me many times. So, next, what happens if you get many errors? Well, you should start with the first error, because sometimes it's the one that caused all the problems. In this example, I get a lot of compiler errors, but they're all telling me that they can't find the same struct. If I go to the first error, we can see why. Here is the problem. Also, sometimes the compiler can report errors in the wrong place, like one line in front or something. Like here. We get again many error messages, but don't worry, let's read the first one. This is the error message, and this is the code. This is weird, where is that semicolon missing from? Well, this is where experience comes into play. For weird bugs like this, you need to use your intuition and knowledge about the language to try to guess what the problem is. Then try to fix that, and if it doesn't work, try another guess. Sometimes you can forget to add a semicolon in the header file, and this can lead to errors in other places. So if we start searching into the header files included by the CPP file, we will eventually get here, and here is the problem. Keep in mind that this error can also be reported from other weird places. If you get errors from weird places, and can't even understand where the problem is, you have to do something different, so to illustrate that, let's talk about template errors. Template errors are usually reported from weird places, more exactly, from the header files that they come from. But remember that CPP files are the ones that they get compiled. So we should figure out what CPP file the problem comes from. To do this, we look at the error message and see what CPP file they come from. There we go. This is the CPP file that has a problem somewhere. Now, you should compile your project often, so you find compile errors early. Let's say that from the last time I had compiled this project, I added this template thing here. So I know that the problem has to be from here. I'll tell you what to do, if you don't have any idea where the problem is from later. But first, let's solve this. So if you pass this error to ChatGPT along with some information, it will actually tell you what the problem is. And that is that an unordered set needs to be able to apply a hash function to your data type. For custom data types, you need to give it a hash function, and ChatGPT can even tell us how to write it. But once you know these things, you'll solve these errors faster. Now you know that these data structures might require some custom functions if you use custom data types, but you could have found this info online or by asking ChatGPT. Now, what if you added a lot of stuff and don't know where the compile error comes from? Well, first, check again from what CPP file is it. And keep in mind that it can also come from a header file that is added in that CPP file. Using this information and also knowing what you had recently added, try to roughly estimate where the problem is. Now, this is what I call Stalin debugging. Comment out all the problematic code until you don't get any compile errors. And then start adding code back until you find exactly where the error is. I know this sounds stupid, but trust me, you'll thank me someday for this. And finally, we get to a cursive includes and then linker errors. These are the most annoying errors. So recursive includes are illustrated very nicely in this Stack Overflow question. This is the code, and the problem goes like this. Main.cpp includes a.age, then a.age includes b.age, before defining the a class. So b doesn't know what a is. The solution to things like this is to forward declare the class, and this looks like this. This tells the compiler that that struct exists, but since it doesn't give it information, you can only do this when you use that struct as a reference or a pointer, because pointers are always the same size. If you need to use that struct normally, you need a full declaration before it. So usually, in a big codebase, the solution is to take that struct as a reference and forward declare it instead of including that header file. Then in the CPP file, you can usually safely include the full class header file. As a rule of thumb, to avoid this problem, try to include things like constants in their own header files, rather than header files that have many classes. Try to forward declare your structs if possible, rather than including the file. And also, if you get weird compiler errors after you add an include file, you should suspect that including that header file is the problem. So try to do Stalin debugging to see if that solves the problem. Also, sometimes changing the include file order matters. So we can try to move that new header file around to see if that fixes the problem. Finally, we get to linker errors. Linker errors usually tell you that the linker can find a function that you used in one translation unit anywhere. If you use a library and that library gives you linker errors, that means that you haven't linked to it properly. There are many cases here that can give you problems, like changing compiler settings or you just forgot to link to it. But searching online or asking ChatGPT actually can help you quite well, fortunately. I recommend searching online for a tutorial on linking to that library, because sometimes some libraries require you to define certain things. If you want some help with linking to libraries, I suggest using CMake, and I have some nice tutorials on that. Now, if you didn't link to another library and you get linker errors, that means that the compiler can find your function. And there are many reasons that can give you this problem. Like you have the wrong function name, or maybe it is declared differently, or maybe you declared it twice. This can happen if you add a not inline definition in a header file. Rookie mistake. Also, inline and static things can be seen by outside translation units. Now, the good thing is that the compiler will give you some info, more or less, so you know where to search for. I suggest saving this video to rewatch it later if you ever need, and also to join my Discord server, because you can ask people or me for help directly. So, this is the conclusion. If you found this video helpful, share it to others, and why not subscribe? I'm trying to get to 50,000 subscribers by the end of the year. And also, thanks to the channel members for supporting me. Now, maybe check out my CMake videos. See you there!